Rob Nash is a farmer, but he doesn't worry about alkaline soil or amending clay. He doesn't have a tiller or weeds or a huge water bill. Instead, he quickly harvests robust crops for the market in his aquaponics greenhouse. He's living his dream job.
Like so many people, my seventh year at my office job at the insurance company, I decided, you know, this is just not something I see myself doing for the rest of my life.
He went for his passion, growing local food for families. His avocation led him to aquaponics after 7 years with hydroponics. In 2012, he built the first of two greenhouses on rocky land that would never support food crops. An innovator, he grows two methods of aquaponics culture, a wicking bed, and some hydroponics. Rob named his new farm Hannah Lee after his daughters, Hannah and Riley. His wife, Lacey, a preschool teacher, and daughters applaud his mission for healthy, local, and resourceful food.
I think it's neat. I tell them all the time, you know, you're the namesake. This is your farm, too.
It's kind of fun because all my friends, when they ask what my dad does, I get to tell them all about this, and they seem pretty interested in it.
What is aquaponics? Actually, it's a combination of aquaculture, raising fish, and hydroponics, soilless agriculture.
When we put the two together in a constructed, closed-loop ecosystem, we get the benefit of nature's bacterial processes. So by combining fish, plants, and bacteria, we wind up with a symbiotic relationship where the fish provide nutrients for the plants, the plants filter the water for the fish.
There are two methods. One is media-based, where Rob combines local pink granite and river rock. Every 30 minutes, fish tank water pumps to the beds. Worms and bacteria break down ammonia from fish waste into nitrites and eventually nitrates, a natural plant fertilizer. The gravel also separates the solids. The process returns clean water to the fish tanks. Rob also directs some of the cleansed water through an external filter to his raft beds, the second method of aquaponics culture.
So now that the water has gone through the media beds and the additional filter, it comes in here into this raft, which we basically have about 12 inches of water, which gives you plenty of room for the roots to grow down. We run air through here so that this is hyper aerated, which gives the plants the more vigorous growth. And as you can see, by running it through the filter, you keep these nice clean roots.
He starts from seed and coir fiber to reduce pathogens. Mature transplants move into net pots for the rafts.
We're able to produce a lettuce in 45 days that would typically take 60. Here is a lettuce that's only been in the system for right at 45 days, and it's ready to harvest.
In the media beds, he transplants directly.
With aquaponics, we're typically allowed to plant our plants as much as twice as dense as in ground.
Multitasking water and space, Rob pumps water from the rafts to a few hydroponic towers and back again to the rafts. He grows with water efficiency in a wicking bed too.
Wicking beds are a great way to grow organic produce without the electrical requirements of aquaponics. A wicking bed is a box with a waterproof liner in the bottom, and then we will put a media in there such as gravel so that we can flood that bottom 6 inches with water. On top of the gravel, we would use a weed block and then put our core soil blend on top of that. And that keeps the roots from growing down into that water reservoir.
Through a PVC pipe, Rob fills the basin with homemade compost tea. He tops off the bed with fish water and granular organic fertilizers.
Moisture wicks up through the soil and the soil stays perfectly moist without you having to water it daily.
Rob chose tilapia for his fish tanks.
Tilapia, however, is a warm-blooded fish that does need this water to remain warm throughout the winter months. By keeping the water 60 or 65 degrees, the fish will continue to metabolize the food at a useful rate. That keeps the plants growing through the winter, which is really the goal.
As Rob demonstrates in classes on his patio for home gardeners, aquaponics can be done outside as long as fish are protected from critters and the water temperature kept warm. He has ultimate control in the greenhouse, though. where he grows basil even in winter and carries winter crops like kale and lettuce through the end of June.
If I add a small chiller wall or an evaporative cooler and some additional shade, I should be able to grow lettuce throughout the summer.
It's important to maintain a ratio between fish and plants. It's easy to test with a typical hobby aquarium kit. He also tests pH.
In Central Texas, with our alkaline water, pH is always considered an issue. There is a point, as your system matures, at say 3 to 6 months, where the system will become acidic and you will begin to have to raise your pH. And so having a high alkalinity water, such as Central Texas, is really to your benefit.
The biggest advantage is water conservation.
With aquaponics, there's absolutely zero waste. The only water that's added to the system is due to plant uptake and evaporation. One perspective is, if you think about watering your lawn with a garden hose for even 30 minutes, you can use as much as 300 or 400 gallons of water just in a small 1,000 square foot lawn. Same thing with a garden. You know, if you ran your garden hose for an hour, it could be as much as 600 gallons of water. In this entire greenhouse facility, we use less than 400 gallons per week.
Rob markets to restaurants that value local food picked just today and just for them. You'll also find him at the Lone Star Farmers Market, thanks to assistance from intern Johnny Wold. The real dream is a family commitment to make a difference. Live here, eat here.
Mostly, we are all just really proud of Rob. Rob has been working on this for a long time, and we haven't exactly been able to be a part of it every step of the way, but we've always been there supporting him, and watching him make this come to life is really exciting. It's really exciting for us. We're really proud of him.